When we were growing up, we were really encouraged by our parents to do some kind of service. And I don't care what you have or think you have or what you don't have, everyone has something to give. Go ahead and find a way to give back.
Not been to Lions Park on a Saturday morning, you just do not realize what tennis is all about. It's constant chatter between the people playing.
What's the ruling on taking drugs once the match has started? Mr. Richardson, can I get a ruling?
We have basically a senior group of people who love tennis. The best thing about it is fun. Periodically we have fish fries and those types of things.
Oh man, he's outstanding in person. Great teacher.
Oh, James, man, great guy. The epitome of just what a man should be. Outstanding gentleman. Ain't no
change in the world. Mr. Richardson, his gift with children, his love for children, he became a childhood mentor of mine.
Upon graduation from college in 1965, I accepted a teaching job at Opelika, Alabama, and it was teaching science and mathematics. During the process there, one of the principals in Mobile said if I wanted to, he would love to have me as a teacher here, and so I ended up back in the Mobile County Public School System, which I stayed in for 40 years. I was also tennis coach at LaFleur High School.
I played for him in the spring. I was a beginner, so I didn't get a whole lot of playing time. I played with Coach Richardson as much as I could.
Lakeith and I practiced every day from 6:30 till 8 o'clock, and he became the number one player on the tennis team, and he earned the scholarship his senior year to attend Tennessee State University.
My math skills didn't improve as quickly as my tennis skills did. So Mr. Richardson, right here at Lions Park, would work with me on with my math, as he did with many other youth during that time.
I accepted a job part-time working with the recreation department. I am still with that particular job, and that was about 45 years ago. And somehow I couldn't let my math go, so I decided that I would tutor students here at Lions Park.
He also helped me with primarily my math, but if I had other subjects that I needed help in, he would help me out with that also. And I owe much of my success today for the leadership, the mentorship that Coach Richardson, that he provided for me very, very early in my life. Today, I can call him not only my mentor, but he's my friend.
He's just been like a second father to me. Anytime I needed help on something, whether it was math, tennis, or just life experience, he was there to help me. Mr. Richardson knows any level of math, like any kind of math, and he can just answer your question just like that.
It may not be known by a lot of folks, but there's a contest called the Arthur Ashe Essay Contest, in which students are writing to compete with every other NJTL that's in the country. During the last 15 years, we have had 5 national winners, and at least 8 state winners.
Being a retired English teacher, I've done a lot of the reading of the essays and that type thing, and that's been just such a joy because some of the writing is very, very impressive. I just hang around the park sometimes and work with kids. I've worked with them in writing and in grammar and that type thing, but I don't put nearly the time in it that James does because he's up here all the time.
These are alternate interior angles, right? And what's true about alternate interior angles? They are congruent. If you don't get this one, I'm gonna break this pencil. What's common to both of these? PS or SP?
I started coming here in 9th grade when I was really bad at math, and he helped me a lot because I went from an E student to a B student in math. And that really meant a lot to me because I was just pitiful and I didn't think I was gonna pass to 11th grade.
He helped me a lot and the teacher's impressed because of one day I come in the classroom, don't understand it, and the next day she's like, wow, how did you ace this test? I'm like, well, I have tutoring from Mr. Richardson and he helped me.
I was having trouble in math class, and so my mother heard about Mr. Richardson from some of her friends, and so she started bringing me down here to get help. He breaks it down in a good way that children can understand it, that some of the teachers might not break it down for them.
I also decided there must be a way we can get more of our kids involved in tennis or some other sport other than football and basketball. There was a National Junior Tennis League going on here under Mr. James Bibbins. He kind of accepted me as a sidekick to go along with this. After he became ill, it was kind of turned over to me, and one of the highlights of my life is that we were chosen to be a national award winner, and several of us, including myself, had an opportunity to visit South Carolina and received the award. And I just enjoy watching young ladies and young men grow into being tennis players and having an opportunity to go to college. And even if they don't, it's something they can do for the rest of their lives. During a week, I would estimate upwards of 80 students come by. I always let every child be successful at doing something. And as a result, they really get into studying, and I think I'm able to put things where kids can comprehend. I want it to be as simple as possible. And the same thing with tennis. If you're out there and the child is having a hard time hitting the ball of any kind, and eventually you are patient and keep working with them, and all of a sudden they're able to hit a couple of forehands, backhands, they are screaming and happy and hollering, and that's what it's all about, just seeing those rewards. I think my grandmother told me at an early age, if you want to praise God, do so by helping other people, and I found out that to be something I can live with.
We've always been very, very proud of him because he devotes so much time to whatever he's doing, and he really loves the kids, and he devotes a lot of time to the kids. He has set the bar high for all of his siblings, and in terms of community service and doing those type things, I think he surpasses everyone that I know because he does it and he doesn't expect anything in return. It's the joy of doing it that probably motivates him and makes him want to do it. And for that, we're so proud of him for that. Very, very, very proud of him.
Take care of the children. The little